Now, there was big news out of Ukraine over the weekend, and it spells trouble for the Democrats. Former Ukraine chief prosecutor Viktor Shokin has admitted he believes that Joe and Hunter Biden received bribes in exchange for forcing him out of office in early 2016. And the details are damning. Shokin told Fox News that Biden had threatened to withhold over $1 billion of aid to Ukraine to protect his son's business dealings from scrutiny by Ukrainian authorities in 2016. He said Biden had him sacked as chief prosecutor after he began to investigate gas company Burisma, whose board Hunter Biden joined in 2014. He even claimed that Biden handled Ukraine like it was his own backyard during the Obama administration. Listen to this.
Do you believe that Joe Biden or Hunter Biden got bribes?
I do not want to deal in unproven facts, but my firm personal conviction is that, yes, this was the case. They were being bribed. The fact that Joe Biden gave away $1 billion in U.S. Money in exchange for my dismissal, my firing, isn't that alone a case of corruption?
Shocking stuff. Let's get the latest on international news and politics. Joining me to discuss is Sky News contributor Kosher Gaider and former Labor MP Michael Danby. Michael, Kosher, welcome to the program.
Hi, Rita.
Kosher, let's start with you. Is Biden in trouble here? I fear not, because a lot of this stuff we knew before the last election. In fact, there's video of him boasting about some of this. I played it before the election, and yet it seems to just, I don't know, it doesn't seem to spark the curiosity of the media at all.
You're 100% right. So I would say it depends. Is he in trouble or not? It depends. The facts certainly are not pretty. Everything that you mentioned, he's on tape boasting it. Even if you know nothing else, we know Hunter Biden is a hot mess, and he was on the board to the tune of $80,000 a month with no expertise when he has, you know, troubles with addiction, etc. So that's not a good look.
No.
Will it matter, though? Legally, the only investigatory body that has any authority over here is the House right now, which is in there very tenuously, very narrow margin. If that changes, that whole line of inquiry, you know, would get shut down. The other is if a Republican takes the House, Trump or somebody else, and maybe that's another pathway, but, you know, that's very much up in the air as well. Politically, maybe it's hurting him a little bit within his own party, but who knows? As you pointed out, I don't think there's a lot of curiosity around this.
This is the issue, Michael. Unless you're reading the New York Post or watching Fox News, you're probably ignorant about this outrage, unlike the Russian conspiracy theory, which was, you know, front page news for 4 years based on nothing. And here we've got real evidence of wrongdoing and really not much fallout. We've got the Washington Post, for example, slandering Shokin as a not a reliable narrator and trying to downplay the significance of these revelations about Biden's dealings in the Ukraine. Do you accept what the Washington Post is saying here?
Journalists like the Washington Post should get back to good old investigative journalism. Over the weekend, Fox, especially journalists, John Solomon, also came out with the fact that the instructions that were given to Joe Biden when he went to Ukraine by the State Department, authorised by Barack Obama, were to give the money to the Ukrainians and not sack the prosecutor. He did the exact opposite. Now, I don't know the reasons why. There are all kinds of people who have their beliefs about certain Burisma boards taking place, but all I know is they should check. The Washington Post should track down George Kent, who was the leading State Department official who said to Vice President Biden at the time, your son's presence on the Burisma board while you're coming to Ukraine is a potential conflict of interest.
That's an understatement.
At the time.
We know what we know about Hunter Biden now. A crack addict, a whore enthusiast, a man with really no qualifications to be sitting on a board of an energy company, let alone collecting the sort of salary he was collecting. The chutzpah here is astonishing from the Biden family. They haven't even tried to be artful about what looks like corruption.